.tv, on the website, our website, but they're not on the big network. But those positions are very, very valuable, because I remember this kid, Terrence Crawford, fighting on so many of our cards, and I would talk to Peter Nelson, other people at HBO, how good he was and what a great prospect he was, and they might not otherwise have an opportunity to see him. So earlier this year, we were doing a 140-pound interim championship, WBA, Khabib against Prescott, and Khabib hurt his shoulder a couple of weeks before the fight, and we had to look for a substitute opponent. And having seen Terrence Crawford perform so many times, we immediately thought of him. Now, there was a debate whether he was ready, whether he had enough time. So we put it to him and to his co-manager. And they said, absolutely, we're ready. Brian McIntyre told me this is a great opportunity, even if it was 24 hours before we would take the fight. And not only did he come in and be competitive with Prescott, who was a weight division above him, but he gave him a boxing lesson and won a clear-cut victory. So now, when it came to making another fight on HBO, there was no problem selling a Terrence Crawford fight, because now Terrence Crawford is recognized by everyone, and he's recognized as one of the best, if not the best, 135-pounder out there. So this is a real true story of how boxing works. It's not a Cinderella story, it's a story. You know, this is how Lou Gehrig replaced Wally Pipp. You know, he got the opportunity. For those of you who don't remember, Wally Pipp was the first baseman for the Yankees, and Lou Gehrig was a rookie. And Pipp got injured, and Gehrig came in and replaced him, and never relinquished the first base position till he had set all kinds of records for consecutive games played. So Terrence stepped in. He was the Lou Gehrig of boxing of our time. And here he is performing on the big stage as an HBO fighter in what should be a tremendous fight. So from Omaha, Nebraska, I'd like to welcome Terrence Crawford and his